Leo 的爸爸妈妈虽然是来自英国，但他就在香港土生土长，由细到大住在西贡或者南区等等的近郊地方，一直对大自然都抱有热情。就算大学的时候在英国都是修读环境管理和生态保育，毕业论文亦都是有关香港的郊野公园管理和在香港可以见到的野生中华穿山甲。
And it's one of the most trafficked animals in the world because, you know, a lot of its scales get taken away for sort of Southeast Asian medicine. And a lot of the information and the research that I was using to base my studies on actually used camera trap surveys. From there, I basically bought my own cameras and put them to the test in Hong Kong to just try and find, you know, these species myself and see what I can really, really capture on film. Yeah, I think it really exists. I hope it does. Because if it does, then it really gives a bit of hope that they haven't been poached to extinction.You know, if I could find one, it would really make me feel pretty positive about the situation.
大概在五个月之前 ，Theo 就忽发奇想，尝试在山入边放低一部动态感应相机。他觉得可能有机会拍摄得到穿山甲的踪影，或者有啲住在香港更加有趣但系未知的生物。不过当然罕见的动物又怎会俾你随便咁样拍摄得到啊？Theo 在第一次嘗試的時候就拍攝得到本土野外常見的箭豬，他更加開了個 Instagram 來分享。
Well, I actually started it for fun. So I just really like to go on hikes, and I thought that by putting cameras out, I would have to hike back. So I forced myself to do more hiking. But as soon as I created the page, and as soon as I posted my first few videos, and some people were messaging that platform, basically just saying, "Oh, I didn't know this existed. I didn't know that." And I think it was that moment of being like.How can we all live in a city of 8 million people where a large percentage of the population don't even know that all of this is on their doorstep? So I think that was the critical moment where it was just like, geez, we need to maybe push this a bit more forward and try and get more footage and more videos and build a bit more of an understanding. So, you know, even there, just a very basic animal, if nobody knows that that exists, how can they possibly appreciate that there's also, you know, crab-eating mongoose, there's Chinese pangolin, there's yellow-bellied weasels and the rest of it. So,You know, just to get the ball rolling, I think it's really important just to make people at least aware of what's in the rainforest that, you know, surrounds one of the most densely populated cities in the world. So right now we're obviously in a bit of a deep forest. We'll probably be looking for maybe deer, pigs. You know, I've had monkeys in areas like this before as well, so rhesus macaques. These are the kind of animals I'm looking for here. I've looked for a bit of a wide opening, so larger animals can get through here as well as the small ones. So,Hopefully looking for animals like that. So that should be set now. Drop my whole one.
儘管做足資料搜集和觀察判斷，但其實主要都是靠運氣。有時覺得理想的位置可能一條片都冇，亦都有時因為風大，啲樹係咁搖晃而不斷咁樣觸發到相機。放咗一個月之後，可能只係得到300條見到樹葉嘅影像。唯有就在失败入边学习和再尝试其他位置，最终就被他拍摄到呢一啲啦。
Well, I'm a big fan of the wild boar. I quite like that they kind of go into the city and you can see them at, you know, Bank of China sliding down the stairs there and everything like this and going through bins. But in my footage, I think the leopard cat was quite a special find. So that was quite unique. I think it is quite rare in Hong Kong, and I think that was brilliant to get. There are really remarkable moments for me that I found really cool. I found.Like a pack of monkeys came down, threw past my camera, a troop of monkeys. So there was about eight to about 15 of them. One of the monkeys had one arm, so he was actually missing an arm. So it's always unique to get a specific type of animal, but then it's always nice to then go one step further and have something unique about that animal too.
還有一個他覺得很深刻特別的影片。但呢一个好似唔系野生动物嚟噶噃。
Yeah, it's funny. Did when a hiker gave my camera the middle finger or something like this. So it's interesting what the public like and what they find funny or everything like this. So I found that actually, whenever I'm hiking, maybe 4 or 5 hours into the country park, I'm thinking that I'm actually really far away from human civilization or I'm far away from human impact and contact. But actually, in fact, a lot of the time, no matter where I put it, there will be hikers that set off the motion sensor. So even if I go as far as I possibly can, you know, I'll still hear music coming up the path and I'll still see people in their boots walking through. So there is a lot of human contact. I think that's why a lot of the animals in Hong Kong are nocturnal. So they're active in the night and a lot of them try to avoid humans at all costs. So that's why it takes so long to basically try and find them because they don't want to be found, right? So if I leave it for 1 month or 2 months,I might only get 3 videos. And I think it's because they are quite solitary and they are, you know, very secretive with their activity, I think. I think the wildlife in the biodiversity in Hong Kong is really good. Hong Kong used to be home to tigers and elephants and things like this a long time ago, and people seem to forget that. So I think compare it to the UK where you have badgers and rabbits and foxes and, you know, it's not as exciting as what you can get in Hong Kong. So I think the diversity here is amazing. I think there's about 50 species of mammal in Hong Kong. A lot of them are bats. A lot of them are small rodents like rats and mice and things like this. So I'm really focused on getting the large mammals. But there's also about 60 different snakes, so I'm quite interested in capturing various types of reptile too. But in terms of a specific animal, I think the Chinese pangolin would be the best one to find. So I mean, the goal of the page is to reach as many people as I can in Hong Kong. I thought it was very worth continuing and really worth pursuing just to really try and build that conservation awareness within Hong Kong and really help people understand, you know, what are the issues in Hong Kong? Why should we care about these things? And you know, how can people care about these issues with, you know, with development where you dump waste in the sea? Why should people care about these issues if they don't even know what animals live here? So I'm using my page to really try and highlight, you know, which animals are here and really then generate a bit more interest and a bit more concern from the public within Hong Kong. The more people that are aware of the issues, the more people have the chance of really trying to help out and tackle some of the problems and some of the environmental issues that are going on in Hong Kong. But I think even just posting a video of a leopard cat, just to go back to that video, I think really the feedback from that alone, if someone's saying, oh wow, you have that here, that even just that small step is quite important, I think.
No,